So we're continuing to make our way through concrete mathematics, the Graham, Knuth, and Patashnik. And this particular section we're looking at is actually section 2.5, but we're looking at different ways that you can take something that is a summation, or really anything, and rewrite it in a closed form. So we've had methods like look it up, guess and check, using perturbing the sum, using the repertoire method, and now we are looking at doing this with integrals. So as you know, you can estimate summations. Well, really, integrals are just really, really fancy summations. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to take this kind of thing. We're going to look at it as kind of being a function, and then we're going to graph it and kind of take it from there and see what we come up with. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to go in and we're going to graph n squared and see how n squared is related to box of n. So box of n, let me graph the box of n's first. So box of n at 0 is 0. Box of n at 1 is going to be 1. So we've got 1. And I'm actually going to so then box 2 at let me try this again. What I'm going to do is I'm going to draw these out a little bit more carefully, maybe. So like if I do this one here, if I draw it going kind of this way, okay, then I can say that if I have this graph drawn, then I can say that the area under the curve of box n, and this is for lack of a better way to do it, from dn to 0 to 1, the area under that curve would be 1. Okay, so I'm not going to call this the graph of box n, I'm going to call this the graph of flower. So this is my flower graph. So the integral of flower dn, as n goes from 0 to 1, the area under that curve is going to be 1, which is equal to box sub n. All right, maybe that makes sense. So I also want to set it up to where the area of the curve from 0 to 2 is, I want it to be equal to 5. So sorry, that would be d sub, or box sub 1, and this one will be box sub, I keep writing it, this will be box sub 2. All right, so if I want the area under the curve, then that means that this one needs to be at 4. Okay, so 4. Okay. So the area under this curve is 1, and whenever I make this curve 4, then 1 plus 4 is 5. Okay, kind of getting it? Same thing at 3. So basically what I'm going to end up doing is I'm going to make the boxes at the squares. So here this is going to be at 9. So 3 squared is 9. So I have kind of a step function, really. So the area under this particular box is going to be 9 times 1 is just 9. But if I do the area under the curve of this flower thing from 0 to 3, then I'll have 1 plus 4 plus 9, which is 15, which is box sub 3. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and continue that. Okay, now, so this is basically just a step function. And if you want to kind of draw these extra lines in here, you can. Oh, there we go. So now it's pretty. So the area under this flower curve is going to be equal to that box sub n term. Okay. Now, the next thing I can recognize looking at this is that, well, I can just draw this in as an n squared. So I can easily, easily, but without too much effort, draw in the n squared graph. All right. So I've got my n squared graph in here. All right. And then I have my kind of a step function with the area under the curve of a step function. Okay. So what I can do now is I can say, okay, well, the area under the curve of that n squared term from 0 to, you know, wherever is going to be equal to the box sub n term, but it's not going to quite have enough in there. So you can see that each, if I was going to take the area under the curve, there's going to be a little error for these, whatever you call it, these little sections here. I can't really get them all drawn in very, colored in very well. But basically, all of these are going to be an error. Okay, so everything here is an error that I've got to account for. So I'm going to have this plus some kind of cumulative error that adds up over time. I just can't really color these others in blue because my highlighter is too big. But anyway, so all of those errors add up, and they're cumulative over time. So again, we're going to call e sub n is the sum of all the little errors. Okay. Actually, sorry, I have that backwards. What I really should be saying is this is minus, so maybe it's a little bit easier to put it this way. So the area under the curve, how about this? This is better. The area under the curve plus all the little errors is going to be equal to box sub n. And again, this is still the sum of all the little errors. It doesn't really matter if we have, I can't spell. It doesn't really matter if we put the errors being positive or negative, because it'll just turn out the same in the end. But for the interest of consistency and just kind of making it make more sense. So again, the idea is if I take the area under the curve, I'm close to having the answer for box sub n, but I have to add some error that gets bigger and bigger and bigger over time. Okay. So now, again, the whole point is I'm just trying to find a closed form solution to this thing, even though I've found it like three other ways. We're just practicing using other methods. So I can do integration to figure this out. Okay. So I can say, okay, well, if I'm going from 0 to n, well, I can just go ahead and integrate that. I've got 1/3 n cubed going from 0 to n, and we're going to call that equal to box sub n minus e sub n. I'm not really sure. We'll just call that n cubed. All right, so there we go. We've got that there. Actually, let me go ahead and solve for e sub n, so get e sub n by itself. So e sub n is going to be equal to box sub n minus 1/3 n cubed. All right. Now, similarly, we can also say that e sub n minus 1 is going to be to box n minus 1 minus 1/3 n minus 1 cubed, like that. All right. Good. Amazing. Now, we're also going to remember that we can describe box sub n as equal to box sub n minus 1 plus n squared. And we did that in another video, but just as a quick review, the idea is you can come in here and you can make this go from k equals 0 to n minus 1, pull the k, pull the n squared term off, and this is just box sub n minus 1. So box sub n minus 1 plus n squared and is another way to write box sub n. Okay? So let's see what we can do with this. So I'm going to take, let's try this again. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this here, and we're going to say, all right, so that means that e sub n is equal to, and we're going to plug this in there, box sub n minus 1 plus n squared. So we're going to substitute that in, and then minus 1/3 n cubed, right? We can also come here and we can solve this for box sub n minus 1 as being e sub n minus 1 plus 1/3 n minus 1 cubed. So we'll, box looks funny. So we can go ahead and plug that in. So this is kind of crazy, and it's one of those things you just kind of mess around with the algebra until you get it to work. I just think it's kind of brilliant that you can all end up with the same answer over time. I know, spoiler alert, we get the same answer that we already knew, but we're finding it a different way, just to kind of experiment. So anyway, we're describing these errors. So we're trying to get a recursive definition for the error, or at least a definition for the error one way or the other. So e sub n minus 1 plus 1/3 n cubed minus 3 n squared plus 3 n minus 1 plus n squared minus 1/3 n cubed. So again, I'm just going to kind of algebra my way through this for a little bit. Finally, because this is probably one of the more stressful ones, just because if you don't think naturally in, what do you call these things? Integrals can be kind of weird. So there we go. And actually, that's kind of nice because this term cancels out and this term cancels out. So now we've actually got ourselves a nice little recursive definition of what that error is going to look like. And since it's recursive, we do want to go ahead and give it a base case. If we look at the error at zero, well, since we're looking right here, the error at zero is just going to be zero because the answer is zero both ways. So we can set that up as e sub zero is being equal to zero. Okay. Now we're going to go throw this back into the other definition. But what I mean by that is we're going to take, instead of writing it recursive, now we're going to take the recursive and we're going to write as a summation. And again, this is something we've done in other videos. So what's really cool about this particular chapter in the Knuth Patashnik Gram book is that this is kind of a almost like a final exam review for chapter 1 and 2. So this is a very dense book. But okay, so I've got this and I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to rewrite it as a summation. So I'm going to start with the E sub O term, and then I'm going to go K going from 1 to N, and then this is the new term that gets added every time. Okay, so that's our new term. So again, the idea is we start with the base case, and then every time we add the new term, that's just like having a recursive definition. So we've rewritten this as a summation. Again, this turns out to be 0. All right, so we're going to try and go ahead and get ourselves a nice little closed form for our error. So our error is going to be given by k going from 1 to n of k minus k going from 1 to n of 1/3. So we know the first one, that's just n times n plus 1 over 2, because we've done that a million times, n times n plus 1 over 2. The second one is 1/3, but we have n of them, so just 1/3 n. So e sub n, let's see if I'm going to find common denominators. I've got 3n squared plus 3n minus 1 over, or minus 2, yeah, minus 2n over 6. So I've got 3n squared minus plus n over 6. So I now have a closed form for my error, which is good because I can go ahead and I can plug all of that back into my original equation. So now I've found a closed form for the error, and I've defined this here. So I'm going to go ahead, and now that I know a value for the error, I'm going to go plug that in. So I've got box sub n is going to be equal to, let me make sure I got this right, box sub n is going to be equal to the error plus 1/3 n cubed. Yes, all right. For some reason, I'm really paranoid about getting this particular problem messed up. So plus that error. All right, so I've got 1/3 n cubed plus the error, 3n squared plus n over 6. So I've got 2n cubed plus 3n squared plus n over 6. And hot fantasticness, if you see what's about to happen, is we're about to get the same flippin' answer that we've been getting every other way. So again, all I need to do is I need to factor this out, 2n plus 1, and then n plus 1, all over 6. So I'm actually, again, able to get the exact same answer just using a totally different method. So I know this was kind of a crazy video. So again, what we did is we took what we had and we graphed it, and then we estimated it using an integral, okay? So we were, and by the integral that I mean that we estimated it using this n squared integral. We realized that we could describe the function as being this integral plus some unknown error is going to be equal to the thing that we're looking for. So then what we had to do is we just had to use a couple of little tricks to try and isolate that error, get a closed form for the error, and then once we got a closed form for the error, then we just had to plug it back into the original equation, and then we did the algebra and it all came out right. So this is kind of a super weird way of getting the exact same answer. But again, the whole point of this particular set of lectures is to realize that there's like a million different ways to solve a problem. So even if you don't get a flash of inspiration one particular way, you can definitely, you know, try something else until something comes.